I'm from a place where there's only love, where the sun comes up every morning. Why ya boy, ya why ya? Oh, you bright black people and love Jah.
Well, I need to laugh and let your blessing go round.
Hey, listen up, listen up.
Yep, good to go.
When Buster met Capone and him wear a tune. I remember when we skipped the cold curbs and dumped the ball at bat, on the outskirts.
Yeah, there I am, just another crash, trying to chase my big brother Marvin. Yo, welcome back to the channel. My name is Sam, this is MTB Zen Master. Thank you for joining me. So yo, this one, this video is very special. This is a special. One of the coolest things about mountain biking are the people in the sport. This is gonna be my community series where I introduce some of the local riders that I know in my area and I just hang out with my friends. And videos are gonna be as unique as the friends that I'm hanging out with. Yeah, so we're gonna do this in the dancehall style. Yo, big up everybody who loves reggae dancehall music. In the description below, give me some signal. Put up your signal. Yeah. Many of you know, just like you, there are many layers to me and to my identity. I'm originally from New York. Got a Caribbean background. So this video is about the A-Team. I typically get to ride with them during the winters, during normal times. It hasn't happened as much this year. A lot of you have met many of my race friends, but I haven't introduced you to my local friends, the friends that I had before I started YouTube, before I started racing. I was riding with my dude Ed, and then I was riding with the other crew, the A-Team. Who's the A-Team? Well, you know, when you're young, and now even when you're old, you get on the trail, you see some cool dudes and ladies doing some of the cool tricks, big sends, big jumps, big drops, and you're like, wow, look how fast, look how good they are. And when I see my friends, you know what, it's like seeing star signs every time. So in Connecticut, we have a group A riders who are pretty much, in my view, the A-Team. So some of us are old enough to remember the show from the 80s called the A-Team. And if you don't know that show, you can ask your dad or go Google it. It was a rad show for a group of military dudes who go around helping people with situations and blow stuff up. Anyway, this is my story about the A-Team here, my mountain bike A-Team. And this video, you'll see Diana, Jesse, Ryan, and big brother Marvin. This group of people, before I started racing, I was riding with them. So they got to see me and support me transition from the guy and the rider I was to who I am today. And you know, it's just like any other family. We celebrate birthdays together.
Anybody with you, man.
Yo, what's up? So we're here at Kyle's celebrate my man, my big brother, Jesse's birthday.
Right.
Yo, had an awesome time celebrating.
Day.
We got all the crew out. Folks are here.
This stuff isn't bad.
Enjoying a beverage, enjoying a good time, celebrating a good man's Earth Strong.
Thank you very much.
We love you, man. Oh, happy birthday. Man.
We take trips together and argue about directions.
We actually went the wrong way.
No, we didn't. We ended up coming back here twice.
You can't go no other way but the way we came.
There was a trail at the top.
It says closed.
Nah, you saw the first one, right?
It says closed.
Around the barn.
It says closed. The orange sign says closed.
All right, boss.
Support each other.
Oh, you're trying to look pretty, man. That's all you're trying to do.
Yeah.
Pretty Ricky.
Yeah.
Pretty damn Ricky, man.
Thank you, sir.
We make fun of each other.
Hey, listen, I'm not leaving this, man. This, you kidding me? Them sensitive fingers.
Yeah, I got someone in the shop right now. I'm saying,
trust me.
Mine don't get specialized.
Oh, well, sorry, man.
The A-Team, super supportive. Always cheering me on, give me coaching and guidance.
Oh, this is the roller. Where's the beeline? I gotta come back.
Yeah, baby. Got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
That was awesome.
Surprise there. Surprise there.
That was real smooth.
Nice. And that's how it. That's
believe me, Sam.
Supporting me and be a better rider.
No pressure. No pressure. Oh, shit.
Oh,
oh
yeah.
So yeah, what can I say about riding with the A-Team? I mean, my cycling family in Connecticut are so awesome. So now I'm going to talk bad about one of them. So yeah, before I met Marvin, I'd be out riding with Ed or by myself. And then I'd always have some dude coming up to me say, yo, Marvin. Hey, man. Hey, Marvin. Yo, Marvin, is that you? I didn't know who this dude Marvin was, but everyone seemed to think I was him. So I started to be the second Marvin until I became Sam. That's when I got the opportunity to meet Marvin and Jesse and start to ride with the crew. So I realized this dude Marvin is pretty popular because everyone thinks I'm Marvin or I'm the other Marvin. It's like that when you're a person of color and you're first getting started before people get to know you and there's another popular guy that everybody knows, but it's all love. So yeah, big brother Marvin, everywhere he goes, this guy is good people. He makes friends with everybody. He shows nothing but love and support, and that's what we're about. I'm gonna tell you a quick story about what happened on this day in that crash with Big Brother Marvin.
Where's the Elmer?
Hey! Exclusive. Are you ready to go to Jamaica? Give me some signal vibe.
Right, London, Europe.
Yeah, winter riding is pretty good. The weather was awesome this day. I had my GoPro Hero 5 Black. Just had the Evo, just got the Evo SS, and I thought I'd pair them together. I thought it would work out. So here I am at the top, about to take off to go down to Line Street on one of the old school trails. And I gotta tell you, this is one of my favorite runs in the winter because I can do a nice climb and then make my way back down. Something, you know, it gets a little rowdy, but it's fun and it's quick and you're out exercising.
Gonna represent the one that's straight for Jamaica. I'll be gone UK. A busy signal set.
Yeah, and the trail's mostly flat. It has a little bit of up, a little bit of down. As you see, quite a few rocks. Nice and fun.
Are you ready?
Them. Represent where you're born.
Hey.
True enough, hurricane and star.
Hey.
From the crime rate, drop, who no matter about tax, for the gun, them a hustle and a guan.
Hey.
For the gun of the lead, to the lead, you can
hey.
American, American, England.
Hey.
Make sure, say, when you do your phone, you know,
yeah.
Mama visit Western Union.
Hey.
Could be luck with foundation. All the admin.
And once you come off of the pink trail, you get to the carriage road, you cross over to the Line Street trail, which is the gray-white trail. It's an old-school tech trail that you can ride all year round, pretty much. And it's lots of fun. So I stopped for a second to get myself all set up, and then I'm ready to go.
Yep, good to go.
Can you hear me now? A Radigan.
This a Radigan story, real reggae story, foundation story, David Radigan story. Hey, Radigan, remember those days when Skia was the sound, when Busta met Capone.
I was probably thinking to myself, yeah, this is going to be awesome. This is an awesome video. I got the gimbal stabilized. You can see it worked pretty well in terms of the video, but the audio didn't work out because the gimbal motor is right there on the microphone. The motor wasn't balanced, so there's a lot of motor noise. And I think I also put a sock over it to cut back on the wind noise, because this is before I figured out and found out you could use a wind slayer. So I'm off and running. You see, this trail is awesome. Nice little rocky, you know, routes. It's just fun to get out, get some exercise in.
When you ride on the beach, you will make the most fun. When the
them a shift up and tip a town. That a long before some liquor boys start play a sound. Now remember when Radigan come a jump down and prosperity was the bookie man around.
Yeah, I was pretty stoked, and my original goal was to start recording all the segments at Case so I can put out some videos. You know, Case is an awesome place to ride all year round, but it's not easy to navigate. I mean, now we have trail forks, and I think pretty much everything is up on there so you can use it, but it wasn't at the time. So this is back in 2018, and folks are always curious about, you know, what the terrain is like at Case. Case has a variety of terrain, and this is just one of the awesome areas you can ride. So as I got to this section of this climb, I noticed that Marvin was in front of me, and when I looked up, I think I saw Jesse in front of me too, but he had already gone up ahead. He's way up there if you look at the top of the hill. But this section of the trail is pretty steep. It's always awesome fun time going down. Nice steep descent with some rocks and some trees and everything. Going up is not easy. You're climbing up. See how steep it is, because you can see Marvin is right in front of me, but he's clearly up on a higher level. And you can see that he's crawling up, which means this is a pretty steep climb. And that also shows that he's pretty tired. And actually, that's an important part for this next piece of the story. I can't remember what we talked about, but it's probably something about the camera setup, because I'm wearing the gimbal. And I keep making my way up the hill, and you see I walk right past him. Get back on the bike and keep going towards Line Street. So yeah, I'm moving along and trying to get a good pace going. I don't detect Marvin really that close behind me. Coming up on this part of the trail, right at this section, there's an A line and B line. The A line is straight over, straight through some rocks. The B line, there's a nice little 1 foot rock drop. At the time, I wasn't feeling it, so I went around the B line. And out of nowhere, this guy took the A line and jumps right in front of me. I'm start chasing him. I'm like, oh man, he got me again. So I'm riding. I'm trying to stay on his wheel. And man, I made a tight turn. Bad position. Slipped out on these leaves. And I think he had figured out that I fell, because I might have shouted at something. Although I cut the camera off, I was on the floor for a little bit. Marvin asked me if I was okay. I answered.
Yeah, good.
Then he said, "You sure?" And then I said, "Yeah." Then he said, "No, you're not okay." But all this time, he ain't never come back. He's way out in front of me. He doesn't know if I'm bleeding out, what's going on. I'm still there laying on the floor. And then I finally pulled myself together to get up, because it was a hard hit. And there was some rocks under those leaves that I didn't realize were there at the time. Anytime someone takes a fall and they're out with their buddy, 1 second after they hit the ground, it's like, hey, you all right? Well, you know, when you hit the ground, you got to figure out if you're all right first. And usually someone comes and checks on you. This day, Marvin didn't come back at all. He just kind of called out. And it wasn't like him, to be honest, but it was like, yo, why are you coming back to check on me? What's going on? I thought about it after. I was like, yo, this guy didn't really come back. I'm really still stuck on the ground. He ain't lifting it. Nothing's going on. He's like, all right, you'll figure it out. So yeah, after a minute or two, I got up. So I catch up to him again. He asks me if I'm good, and you know, and I'm like, all right, I'm just going to keep going. I didn't say that, but that's what I did. So because I wanted to get some good pace on this section. And you see here, section down in Line Street gets real rocky and rough, but it's fun and fast, and it's a nice little descent. So I just kept going, and he was clearly still behind me.
Somebody say fireman! In their mind, say fireman!
Don't tell us something that you're like a two-year-old champion here.
here. I like it too, we are the man number one. Watch out. Then I like it too, we are more known back here.
What's that?
Yeah, as you can see, this descent is nice and fast and completely fun. So I'm almost at the bottom of the run there, Line Street, and Marvin is not there. He fell back a little. So I'm going full throttle because, you know, I had a fresh pair of legs and I'm feeling good about myself. And this is a descent, which I can do. So I'm almost at the end. This is a fun part.
Hey, we name Sentinel, yes, we are the world champion. From Elmo walk on any stage in any dance and it we done. Batman boot and warrior suit, you think him go Iraqi war. World of sun, boy, they feel a Sentinel, a superstar. Better know some mad people get with it when them a war. We get an inch, you want to feel the grip, you put a fireball. See if it in a me grip on me, yes, we see till it's man. Every bit a little,
come give me the next one.
No, never talk.
So as I'm getting rowdy and having fun, I get towards the end and I look in the parking lot up ahead and I realize, you gotta realize that Marvin was not by himself. He was with a group ride. And when I finally got out into the street at the Lion Street parking lot, it made sense. He was riding with some of the crew, some of the members of the A-Team. So I pull up and you got Jesse and Ryan there. And then a little bit, you see Diana's there, and then it all made sense. So one thing about Marvin is he's fast, he's strong, he's skilled, but he's not the fastest out of the A-Team. These three were sitting up there waiting for him to show up, and you see him coming out into the street now, because I had gotten a little lead on him. So now I realize why he didn't come back for me. They had just finished 20 miles at Case Mountain, which is more than an average 20 miles, especially with considering the climbing. And so they were having a great day of riding out, doing some great winter riding. It made sense why he was tired, because he was riding with the A-Team.
Yo, did you just see that? He stopped right there dead in front of me. I was full throttle and my dude Mike was right there on my tail, and for some reason this guy decides to stop. He's like, oh, I didn't know you were behind me. But here's what happened. Think about this. For a long time, he stops to check to see where's Sam. On this day, I was right there on his wheel. So how's that for progression? So in the meantime, let's deal with Big Brother. He knows better not to stop in the middle of the trail. Buju have a message for you. Yeah. Anyway, in the meantime, in between time, special shout out to Emily, making these hot shirts. Special shout out to Big Sister Diana, Ryan and Queen Andrea. Special shout out to Coswell, to Michael, to brother Jesse, and the rest of the larger A-Team crew. Big brother Marvin. Salute.
Put your butt to what's the face of Radigan, I come again.